5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। द सेकेंड अपील हैज़ बीन डिसमिस्ड बाई द बोर्ड ऑफ रेवन्यू बाई द इम्पेंज्ड ऑर्डर ऑन 11 May 2011, होल्डिंग दैट नो सब्सटेंशियल क्वेश्चन ऑफ लॉ वॉज इन्वॉल्व एंड अकॉर्डिंगली द ऑर्डर्स डेटेड 31 March 2011 एंड द ऑर्डर डेटेड 27 December 2008 वर अपहेल्ड। द प्रोसीडिंग्स अरोज आउट ऑफ अ suit under section 176 of the UPZA and LR Act for partition. The dispute further indicates that it centers around the property acquired under the sale deeds, where in the respondents plaintiffs claimed equal shares to the extent of 1/7 share each, whereas the petitioners defendants contend that apart from the land under the sale deed dated 10 May 1988, where the shares have been indicated as 1/7 each, the share of the other parties which was subject matter of different sale deeds brought on record through a short counter affidavit have to be distributed by allocating 1/8 share to the contesting respondents number 1, 2, 3, whereas the petitioner numbers 4, 5, and 6 are entitled to 1/16 share each. The trial court proceeded with the matter, and from the order sheet it appears that the plaintiff's witnesses were being cross-examined. The order sheet dated 20 September 2008 indicates adjournment of the case on the ground of further cross-examination of the plaintiff witnesses, and the date fixed was 25 September 2008. Learned counsel for the petitioner Sri S.K. Purwar contends that the dispute which was raised with regard to the shares could have been decided and adjudicated only after the cross-examination of the plaintiff's witnesses was completed, but without proceeding with the same and only fixing dates on the application. The suit was decreed on 27 December 2008, which prejudices the claim of the petitioners. He further submits that the petitioners have been denied the opportunity of cross-examination, and the trial court hastily proceeded to decree the suit, depriving the petitioners of the opportunity of putting the witness to cross-examination on that issue. A short counter affidavit has been filed by Sri Anupam Kulshrestha, learned counsel appearing on behalf of the respondents contesting herein, namely respondent numbers 4 to 7. He contends that the sale deeds that are being made the basis of the claim of the petitioners defendants do not indicate any specified share, and therefore a presumption in view of the provisions of section 92 of the Indian Evidence Act is to be made that the plaintiffs and the defendants all had equal shares in the land which are subject matter of the said sale deeds, and hence the dispute which is now sought to be raised by the petitioners is purely unfounded, and proceedings are being pursued on a very highly technical ground. He contends that as a matter of fact, the petitioners are trying to take undue advantage of the absence of one of the brothers of the answering respondents, and the shares were very well known at the time of execution of the sale deed, which also stands corroborated by the sale deed dated 10 May 1988, whereby 1/7 share has been indicated in respect of all the parties.